In today's video, we're gonna showcase a couple things. We're gonna showcase the difference between two basses with flat wound strings and two distinctly different pickups. One in this 55 precision bass from the Fender Custom Shop, and the other in another wonderful and beautiful instrument, the Pino Palladino Signature. So we're gonna go between a split coil P pickup and, in the 55, a single coil P pickup. Let's check it out. What's up everyone, Anthony here with Empire Music, empiremusic.com. Phone number at the shop, 412-343-5299. If you see anything in this video or have any questions about what we're gonna talk about in this video, please reach out to me. You can also just email me, it's anthony@empiremusic.com. Keep in mind, when you get anything here at Empire Music, we do a full factory setup on all the guitars, or basses in this case. Also, if you talk to me on the phone, which is kind of cool about that, or via email, either way, whatever is easiest for you, we decide on a bass. I'm going to be the one that goes and grabs that bass for you. I'm going to get my hands on it, play it, make sure it all checks out, get it to our techs, they do the setup on it, then I get my hands on it again in most cases, make sure that thing's really dialed in before it ships out of here. So keep in mind, not only do we do some, hopefully to you, amazing YouTube content, but we're also a store, so we can also get you a really nice bass or guitar. And today, a little bit of a different video here. I'm gonna do like a small series of videos highlighting some of the products here in the shop. A lot of times, whenever we're closing up, you know, we have 15, 7 minutes. If Joe Revita, our owner and my boss, is watching this, 1 minute, that's all we spend every time, I guarantee it. Now, if we get a few moments here, it's fun to get your hands on some instruments, and you forget a lot of things. You forget how cool some instruments are. You forget kind of how lucky we are to work here at Empire Music, that we get to be surrounded by some of these amazing instruments. We have a pretty vast inventory of us. Some of the stuff, I play just about every bass that comes through the store. That's actually like no lie. Even like multiple colors, I play tons and tons of instruments here. Just real quick, plugged in, not plugged in sometimes. But it's nice to refamiliarize yourself or myself with some of the stuff here in the store. And I love bass, right? I mean, you've hopefully can gather that from, you know, the way that I present these videos and how I talk about some of the products here. But what's important to me with an instrument is reacting to it, getting something in your hands and playing something different, or playing something that that instrument's allowing you to play, whether it be a high setup, a low setup, string tension, fretboard radius, neck radius, all that stuff. And a lot of times it's just sound. And that's really what I want to focus on here for, like I said, it's just a small series of videos just to kind of show some instruments and compare some instruments while we do that. So today, a little bit of examples here of some amazing Fender Custom Shop instruments. So, Pino Palladino Signature Bass. This is a pretty straightforward split coil P bass setup in there. Not even going to get into too many specs on it. And then have a 55 straight single coil pickup in this 55 P bass. So they're both P basses. They're different in the case of ash body versus an alder body. You have a one-piece maple neck with obviously a maple fretboard on this, and a straight single coil pickup. And then the strings are a little bit different here. So these are Fender flats, which remind me a lot of like a D'Addario Chrome. I don't know if that's the exact same string. This is a higher string gauge on this. I believe these are 45 to 105, so like a standard kind of string gauge on it. So it's a higher tension flat wound string, and that's okay. The Pinot, alder body, we have a rosewood fretboard on it, still has the maple neck on it, but rosewood, not maple. And then obviously you have your split, your vintage voiced split P pickup in it. And then I believe this has Tomastic flats on it, which are a lighter string gauge, like 43 to 100 or 103 or something like that. But it's like a low, what I would consider like a low tension flat, right? So they're a little bit more flexible. Labella makes, and we sell like the low tension flats. There's other companies that would call the something called like a flexible flat. And they feel good. So they're a little bit slinky, and they're not quite, there's not quite as much, there's not nearly as much tension on this as there is on that. That's fine. Again, we're not, I'm not doing this exact comparison. We're just really kind of highlighting some of the differences in this bass. And it's really, to me, about the pickup in this case, because you have your traditional, I guess that's actually traditional as the original, but this is what we see in most P basses here, split coils. So meaning you have the two magnets, two coils for the E and the A and the D and the G. Now, what we get there is you have the E and the A a little further up. You know, that's where your magnetic field is. Back here, the D and the G, it's pushed back a little bit more. So we get a little bit more mid-range, a little bit more upper mid-range clarity from here, from positionally. We get a little more roundness, fatness out of the E and the A. And then in the case with the 55, it's just the straight single coil. So you're in, you know, one magnetic field there. These are also an Alnico 3 magnet. This is an Alnico 5 magnet on it. They both are enamel wired. This is much more underwound than when I say that, there's less wraps around there. We put something like that on the multimeter to measure the DC resistance. It generally comes in around the 6.5 mark. Pickups like this generally come in between the 8.5 to 10 mark. That's a little broader range, but there's quite a few iterations of the P-Bass pickup. Even like if you got into a 65-70, you might even push 11.5 or 12. But really the early 60s, late 50s stuff generally comes in, let's say 9, 9.5 DC resistance, which measures the output of a pickup. So this is a much less powered pickup. When you hear me plug into the amp, this is just not gonna have as much volume to it, right? We're gonna listen to some of the tone though out of it. So let's start here in a very traditional sense for what we think of with the modern P bass, and we're playing the Pinot here. So again, we're comparing the flat wounds, both have flats on it, split coil P pickup, so the modern P bass design of the pickup, and the single coil P bass pickup in the 55. Keep in mind, ash body, maple board, rosewood board, alder body on this. But let's just listen to the tone. What sounds right to you? What do you like? What do you hear? How do you react to it? I'll share my thoughts as I play along with it too. So Pinot, full volume, full tone, finger style. Thank you. All right, and the 55 precision bass, again, full volume, full tone. It's very interesting hearing those two basses back to back. So obviously, yes, I noticed the string tension on this being a little bit tighter with the heavier gauge on it. But we really start to dive into the tone of the pickups, and I can hear a little bit of the maple thing going on here. There's that brightness on the attack. It has something to do with the slight, the different string. You know, those, again, the Tomastics versus the again, what I'm perceiving kind of is a D'Addario chrome-ish kind of thing. I like both strings for sure. Every time I play one of these basses, I'm kind of shocked at the amount of, there's a little bit of a brightness to it, even though we have this vastly underwound pickup. Again, on the multimeter, we'll say around six and a half, as opposed to something that comes in 9.5, 10, 10 and a half on it. But you certainly hear the gain jump in that. This is a much quieter bass, right? So you would need to adjust. If you were A-B-ing on a gig, you know, with an A-B box, you really would want to make sure that you have some gain added to something like this to bring that back to volume, where you're going to go back to your amp and turn up a little bit. Just from a playing perspective, though, this is certainly, to me, an airier sound. It's a much more open sounding to me. Obviously, it sounds more vintage-y based on, you know, kind of just what we expect out of it being like the early incarnation of the P bass. This does move, the Pino moves a little bit more towards what we think of with the modern P bass. But flats kind of, I think, narrow that field a little bit there. But this is brighter than you think, certainly underpowered, and again, airy, very breathy, very, it's actually very articulate considering how underpowered it is. And again, with an Alnico 3 magnet, so that's a darker magnet on there, but there's still like this upper end clarity to it. Let's go back to the Pino. We're gonna roll a little bit of tone off of that. We'll play with a couple different techniques. We'll do some palm muting and we'll play with the pick a little bit. Thank you. All right, back with the 55 P bass. Same thing, full volume, tone around 70-75%. Always fun to do these because it really, really is so interesting to have two amazing basses back to back and to hear those differences. Shockingly, a much quieter bass than this, but you really hear the difference in the dynamics. If you check this out, I think my biggest takeaway is with this pickup, it really is so sensitive because there's such a big difference between, you know, and that's like super, super quiet back there. So you have to make that kind of adjustment for it. But they're both awesome instruments. And they both, you know, while I tried to play kind of the same thing between the two each time, it's actually kind of hard. Not because anything was very difficult to play there, just because the basses sound a different way, the way that those notes pronounce differently. When you kind of, I try to be in the moment of an instrument and again, reacting to what the instrument wants to give me. And then when they want to give you different things, you want to play a different way. That's the beauty of playing basses and guitars when you're open to it. So very cool. So just a quick video that ended up being a long video, like it always does. But a nice comparison between a single coil P pickup and a split coil P pickup, and we are referencing with the 55 Precision Bass Fender Custom Shop and the Pino Palladino Signature Fender Custom Shop. I would love to know how you heard that. If you have any experience between these two instruments, I'm sure there's people out there that own both of these. I don't own a single coil P in my personal collection, so it's nice to get a chance to do it here in a very real time situation and just reacting to them, like I said, with you guys out there. So would love to hear your thoughts on it and your personal takeaways that maybe you have experienced in your own playing journey. Give me a call at the shop, 412-343-5299, if you have any questions. Thanks for watching.